Hello, everyone. This is Braden Kelly of BloggingInnovation.com, here with Wendy Kopp, the CEO of Teach for America and Teach for All. Today, just Wendy, I'd like to chat with you a bit about education and some of what you've learned over the last 20 years with Teach for America, and also a bit about Teach for All. Obviously, innovation and education is very important, and as countries start to compete and as countries start to compete for the higher paid jobs around the world, and as countries try to differentiate themselves and bring commerce and continue commerce in their countries, education is very important. So first of all, over the last 20 years with Teach for America, which is a very valuable program that brings new graduates from universities into inner city schools to help bolster the abilities of the educational system in those communities. What have you learned in that program over the last 20 years?
Well, you know, the principle upon which Teach for America is built and really which unifies all the members of the Teach for All network is that this problem of educational need is, you know, our country's and society's most fundamental challenge, but that it's solvable in the face of tremendous leadership. And so the universal truth in all of this is that there's tremendous power in channeling the future leaders of a society against this problem of educational need. And I think the most salient lesson of our work over the last 20 years is simply the solvability of the problem. The fact that, you know, we see every day in classrooms across our country and now really across the world that when kids, in many cases kids who face so many extra challenges, challenges of poverty and such, but when they're given the educational opportunities they deserve, they excel. And I think it's seen evidence of that in classrooms and now in whole schools and seeing even the possibility of system-level change in whole school systems is fueling our sense of urgency to say, now that we know that we really could solve this problem, now we know we have no option but to make it happen.
Okay, and as you look to inspire change in schools, and you know, obviously we're here at the World Innovation Forum, and innovation is the main topic. What are some of the innovations that Teach for America has introduced into the school system in the United States, and also with Teach for All around the world?
You know, I think I would say that probably a huge source of the kind of inspiration and just everything that we are doing has been inspired by those among our teachers who have been successful in literally changing the academic trajectory of their students. And I think what I've learned from them is that there's no magic to succeeding with kids, but there's also nothing elusive. You know, there's no way around the very hard work of making it happen. Like, at the end of the day, teaching successfully in low-income communities in the U.S., for example, is an act of leadership. It's about people who come into a classroom and say, where are my kids, and what do I need to accomplish with them this year that will make a meaningful difference in their lives? And it's about setting a vision, like a great leader would set a vision of, here's where we're going to be by the end of the year. And then, like great leaders do, investing the kids and the kids' families and other influencers in working harder than ever to reach that vision, and then being very purposeful and strategic and just doing whatever it takes and continuously improving. And I think that notion that teaching is leadership is actually maybe one of the great innovations of Teach for America. I don't think it's how most people think about teaching. Like, you know, in the most successful classrooms, the kids and the teachers are on an absolute mission to get from point A to point B. They're not going through motions of lesson plans, you know, and I think if we could achieve a world where that was what was happening in all of our classrooms, we would have a very different society, and we'd have a lot more innovation all around, I think.
Well, definitely alignment is very powerful, and when everybody's going in the same direction, then you can achieve amazing things, whether it's in education or in other types of organizations. So I'm going to ask you a hypothetical question. So if you were suddenly in charge of, say, U.S. educational policy, you were, you know, head of the Department of Education, and you were in charge for creating a more creative and innovative society, what are some of the changes or changes in how people are taught that you might make?
You know, I mean, all of my last 20 years have been spent thinking about the state of education in our country's most under-resourced communities. And in that context, our kids are so far behind. People don't realize the extent of this problem. We have 14 million kids in our country, in the United States, who are growing up below the poverty line, who by the time they're in fourth grade are already three grade levels behind fourth graders in high income communities. Half of them will not graduate from high school, and the half who do have an eighth grade skill level. So we are setting our kids in low income communities up for nothing in terms of the opportunity to have real opportunity in life, certainly not to have a chance at the American dream. You have to seriously beat the odds. So, I personally believe we need to solve that problem if we're going to unleash the potential of, you know, millions of people in our country who have the potential to be active, engaged citizens and incredible leaders given how many challenges they need to overcome. I mean, these are incredibly strong people and resilient folks. So we just have to make an investment in that. And if I was the Secretary of Education, I would do much as the Secretary of Education is doing, which is I would say, you know what, there's no way we're going to solve this problem without serious local leadership and initiative. And I would do everything possible at the federal level to incent greater local leadership and initiative. And that's exactly what they're doing. You know, they've put out there a lot of funding to say we want states and localities to come together around serious change with a priority around the people part of this puzzle, because we all know that if, you know, people are everything in every sector, and maybe all the more so in education. This is about teachers, it's about school principals, it's about school district leaders. There's no way around that. And so it's, you know, we need to think creatively about how to ensure that our country's most talented, committed leaders are channeling their energy against this, the most fundamental of all issues, educational quality.
So, final question. From your experience with Teach for All, which has been going for the last 3 years, you mentioned, are there things that you've learned outside the United States that you've brought back to the United States?
It's been so inspiring to meet social entrepreneurs around the world who are pioneering the development of this model in their countries, launching programs like Teach for India or Teach for Australia, Enseña Chile, Enseña Peru, et cetera. You know, interestingly, I think the most surprising thing I've learned has to do with the universality of the challenges. And I'm really quoting many of them as I say that. You know, I think as we've visited teachers in each other's countries, we've become more and more aligned in our understanding of what it takes to teach in a transformational way and what truly transformational leadership would do in terms of educational quality. So, as much as the world is different the world over, there are so many commonalities. Teaching is leadership, not only in the South Bronx in New York, but in, you know, Lima, Peru, and in Mumbai.
Well, very good. Well, I think that, you know, as you said, the challenges in education are universal. I think the challenges in innovation are also universal. So, again, this has been Braden Kelly of BloggingInnovation.com here with Wendy Kopp of Teach for America and Teach for All.
Thanks.